Hey guys, so this is me continuing to talk about my top 10 favorite boss fights in the Metal Gear series. I think probably I'm assuming that my number 9 is kind of shocking to many of you guys who love Metal Gear, because that's a character that many people would put at like at least top 3, but I put it at number 9. So I understand that's going to be kind of, you know, stirring the pot a little bit. Especially when I mention number 8, I think you guys are going to be like a little bit upset, because maybe you guys will think, well, how can you like this boss fight more than you liked number 9, right? Now, for those of you who haven't watched my previous video, my recap here is my number 10 was Big Boss from Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake, the MSX2 title, so the 2D game, which I haven't actually experienced until like way late, like 2007 or 8 or something, when I finally got to play Subsistence. So Metal Gear Solid 3 Subsistence comes with Metal Gear 1 and Metal Gear 2. But yeah, Big Boss is number 10. Number 9 for me was Psycho Mantis, and I explained that in the previous video. Now let's continue. Number 8 for me is Crying Wolf from Metal Gear Solid for Guns of the Patriots. Now, yeah, like I said, like I'm already hearing you. How can you have Crying Wolf over Psycho Mantis? That makes no sense. I don't know. Like I said, for me, I'm considering the gameplay experience I had, the emotional attachment that I've had after the fight, and also replayability. The reason Psycho Mantis is so low, he's not a very replayable boss fight. Once you have that shock value of that intense awesomeness and you play it again, it's not a very good boss fight. Crying Wolf is a very replayable boss fight. Especially on extreme difficulty, the hardest difficulty, that boss fight is extremely fun. And so tense. It gets so intense. You know, you're using the... It's so hard to see the environment because of the snowstorm and the blizzard. So you have to use the solid eye. That makes it, you know, even tense. But at the same time, like, there's all these Outer Heaven troops surrounding you. And there's really like multiple ways to defeat Crying Wolf. Lethally, non-lethally, you can use a flashbang grenade to feed her. She's always moving around so fast. And it's a really intense, kind of more fast-paced sniping battle. And Metal Gear Solid, I think, boss fights, the sniping boss fights are pretty freaking amazing. But Crying Wolf is up there for me in that experience. Now, the character itself is not very memorable per se. I think it's a very interesting design that, you know, this is actually a person but moves like a wolf. That makes it pretty interesting. It has a rail gun as its tail. So the design itself, I think, is pretty fantastic. I love the design, but maybe like the personality of the character itself, not as much. The backstory behind Crying Wolf is pretty horrific, as told by Driven. But you know, for me, the debate was like, do I pick Sniper Wolf from Metal Gear Solid 1, or do I pick Crying Wolf, you know, for Metal Gear Solid 4? And that was kind of the debate that I had. The reason I finally decided to pick Crying Wolf over Sniper Wolf is because of the gameplay itself and the replayability of it. Sniper Wolf, definitely the character, amazing. One of my favorite characters in the entire series is Sniper Wolf, despite the fact that she has such less screen time in the series. But the speech she makes as she dies is one of the most memorable speeches to me in the entire series. That kind of puts her up there. And the love that Otacon had for Sniper Wolf is also one of Otacon's first loves to end up, you know, that way, and it kind of plots the trajectory of Otacon's, you know, relationship life. And so, as a character, Sniper Wolf, like, definitely over the top, but the whole experience of the boss fight, I'm considering, I would pick Crying Wolf. Now, why do I not pick Sniper Wolf for number 7, then? It's because I already picked Crying Wolf. Also, Sniper Wolf, the boss fight, the two boss fights you have, It's the way sniping is done in the first game, the controls. It kind of is frustrating. You know, you go straight into the first person view mode and you have to snipe and you can't move while sniping. The gameplay is outdated, you know, and I guess you can try to go back to playing the game in the Twin Snakes version. It's a little bit better, but still it's not as fun as Crying Wolf or the other sniping boss fights in the other games. So also, like, because you can abuse the Nikita Missile Launcher in the second Sniper Wolf boss fight. That's why it doesn't make the cut for me. So Crying Wolf is my number 8. Number 7. I think this is going to be pretty weird and unique and surprising to many of you guys. Because not many of you guys have actually played this game. Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker, right? One of my favorite boss comes from Peace Walker. And the boss is Peace Walker. Peace Walker AI is... I don't know why, but I've loved this boss so much. It's just a unique concept, you know. I mean, all the boss fights in Peace Walker are not human; they're all machines. They're either vehicles, like personal carriers, helicopters, tanks. They're all vehicles or machines. There's 4 Metal Gears that you fight in Peace Walker. They're all machines. They have no personality. But Peace Walker itself does have a really awesome personality, because Peace Walker AI is designed off of the boss by Dr. Strangelove. So that itself, like, I think makes it different. The boss fight itself is has multiple stages. The first stage, you have to make it stop from launching a nuclear missile. And once you do that, it just jumps at you. It's this huge, gigantic, 4-legged thing that jumps around, has all kinds of different weapons, flamethrowers, mines, drill bombs, machine gun, laser. It just is this insane thing. And you're fighting it with conventional weapons like your M16 or rocket launcher. And its armor, its AI canisters are vulnerable to conventional weapons, which makes it different than other Metal Gears that you faced before, other than Shagohod, but Shagohod I don't really consider as a Metal Gear, and the game doesn't itself consider it as a Metal Gear, except for Shagohod. Yeah, like, you can defeat this thing with conventional weapons, except at the end, there's nothing you can do about Peace Walker. I think the ending cutscene also makes a huge impact on me. You know, Snake, Big Boss just freaking gives up, like, there's no way we can stop this thing from launching. But then that's when Peace Walker itself decides to sacrifice itself for the good of the world. For the good of the country, really. Because if it doesn't kill itself, it's going to start this whole nuclear war. So Peace Walker decides to go into the ocean and sacrifice itself. And that action has such a big impact on Big Boss that for all this time, he's been calling himself Snake. But after defeating Peace Walker, he says, "'Cause now call me Big Boss." So that's the impact of Peace Walker. It's an extremely fun boss fight. And the more difficult versions of Peace Walker you can play, you have to play with, you know, friends, co-op, because it's an extremely difficult boss fight. It's super fun. It's highly replayable. And the fact that this machine has an AI that is modeled off the boss, that itself, to me, is highly interesting and intriguing. And that's why Peace Walker is number 7 for me. I'll state number 6, and then we're gonna have to cut it for this video. Number 6 for me is another Metal Gear. Metal Gear Rex from Metal Gear Solid 1. Replayability comes into thing as well, but I've always had the fascination with Rex. I think Metal Gear Rex is one of the coolest Metal Gears out there. You know, the way it's designed, the way it roars, you know, it's like a T-Rex. You know, it roars. I love that about Metal Gear Rex. And there's 2 stages to this fight. The first fight, you know, every Metal Gear Ray is, everything is electronic, so you have to jam the electronic devices using a shaft grenade, and then you hit the ray dome. And then after you do that, one of the most coolest cutscenes in the series is Gray Fox fighting Metal Gear Rex. That has such a big impact on me. And then afterwards, you know, you fight Metal Gear by going underneath it. This is crazy. This is this like 50-foot gigantic robot. And how do you fight it? You don't run away from it. You have to run into it and be under it. And that's one of the challenging parts about it. And Liquid gets so frustrated. And this boss fight is actually super fun whether you play the original or Twin Snakes. My problem with Twin Snakes is the gameplay. Like, because it uses MGS2 controls, with GameCube controller was awful because GameCube controller is not pressure sensitive. That makes a big difference. So many boss fights that were carried over to Twin Snakes, it's not very fun. But Rex, in the case of the boss fight against Rex, is still good. And the cutscene that happens afterwards is pretty amazing. I have a problem with some of the voice acting in Twin Snakes, but Rex, whether you play Twin Snakes or the original, is still freaking amazingly awesome to play. To fight against a Metal Gear that like that. I think when I picture a Metal Gear, Rex is the first thing that comes to mind. And battling against it in that manner, as just one tiny little soldier against this gigantic walking battle tank, that's pretty amazing. And to have take it down and on top of that. And then, you know, the boss fight leads to fighting on top of it. That's a different boss fight altogether that is not in my list. Fighting against Liquid Snake on top of Metal Gear is not on my list. Why that is, I don't know. I couldn't really put it on my list. There's so many other amazing boss fights in the series, which I'll get to. So that's my list for now. So just to recap, number 10 is Big Boss from Metal Gear 2. Number 9, Psycho Mantis from Metal Gear Solid 1. Number 8, Crying Wolf from Metal Gear Solid 4. 7, Peace Walker from Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. And 6, Metal Gear Rex from Metal Gear Solid 1. So that leaves 5 more to do, which I'll continue in the following videos. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please feel free to leave some comments down below about your list of your favorite boss fights, and I'll catch you guys later. Cheers.